Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to start with the new session in our video discussion. The new session is a part of immunology that is called as a clinical immunology. In this, various techniques can be studied. Basically, क्लिनिकल इम्यूनोलॉजी के बारे में हम लोग पहले समझने की कोशिश करेंगे कि व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय क्लिनिकल इम्यूनोलॉजी. दिस वीडियो इज फॉर दैट ओनली एंड इन दिस प्लेलिस्ट नेक्स्ट वीडियोस विल बी अपलोडेड विच विल बी फोकस ऑन बेसिक डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स ऑफ क्लिनिकल इम्यूनोलॉजी. नाउ इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट थ्रू दिस चैनल प्लीज लाइक द वीडियो सब्सक्राइब द चैनल and share the videos, okay? And if you have any doubt, you can ask anything in the comment. So before going further, please like, subscribe and share the video, okay? Now let's see what do you mean by clinical immunology. Clinical immunology is needed because we know that disease is caused by bacteria, virus, fungi, that is microorganisms. So which microorganism has caused the disease, for that identification we mainly go for the cultural identification, in which we take the clinical specimen and go for the cultural identification. But if we have consumed the antimicrobial drug before, it may possible that those microorganism will be in less amount, so we cannot able to detect them properly. In those conditions, there should be certain other way to detect the causative agent of the disease, and that is done by using, just by detecting the antibodies which are generated against those causative agent, and we can able to diagnose it. Usually, instead of going for detecting the pathogens with their cultural and morphological identification, we should go with the immunological detection and we can identify the pathogen. This method is sensitive. Immunological detection methods are sensitive. They are very rapid, and apart from this, these are very, very much reliable method. By using this process of clinical immunology, by detecting or by diagnosing with by diagnosing the clinical sample with the clinical immunology, we get the better understanding regarding different immunological cell surface. What are the lymphocytes which are generated against antibody antigen or microbial pathogen, right? What are different antibodies which are generated against microorganism that can be detected, and we can able to identify the development of antibodies, different types of antibodies against those pathogens, like with respect to time also. So overall, this clinical immunology will give us this idea. For analyzing the production of antibodies or antigen, this detection, for detecting this, care must be taken that which kind of test we want to perform. Means utility of this clinical immunology is depend on the proper test selection by the doctor and timing of the specimen collection. Here there is a wonderful example. If you are having infection of something, some bacteria, and you went for the antibody detection and you found that IgG is present, that means that the infection is of good amount of time, means काफी दिनों से वो infection है, from any days the infection is there. And if you find only IgM, then you will be able to conclude that the infection is of initial days. अभी just infection जो है वो start हुआ है. So by using this techniques of clinical immunology, we can also able to identify the timing of disease. Okay, so it is very crucial that a proper test should be selected for the diagnosis of disease, and timing of specimen collection is also very important. It should not be like that ki the antibody are neutralized by collecting the sample and before the test, right? It care must be taken that the sample is collected in a such a way that no negative interference is observed. So this is called as clinical immunology, in which we are going to learn few tests as shown in this as you can see on this on your screen. We will learn this specific test, and the basic of all this test is just the antibody and antigen reaction. Antibodies which are generated by that infection, their reaction with the antigen, that will be the core of every test, and on that basis we are able to diagnose the disease, right? So this area of immunology is called as clinical immunology. Hope you understand the concept. From next video onwards we will see this topic one by one. Okay, thank you. Hope you understand it. If you don't understand this, please have give us any questions in the comment box. Okay, thank you.